Kumwasam, please go ahead and start your presentation.
Okay, yes, okay. Thank you, Mr. Gary. Okay, first of all, I would like to say greeting and Sawadee krap. All of the participants from all over the world, right now is more than 45 participants. Yes, okay. My name is Mr. Thatsit Sukun Pong. Today I am the moderator for this session and welcome all of you for joining the IWA International Water Association to share some knowledge of the water. Especially this time, it's very great time for us to have the seminar and share the knowledge passed through the webinar today. Yes, okay. First of all, I have to say, and hope everyone is safe from the virus corona, because right now in Thailand, it has got a good good condition, because today is around 15 and 16 days that we have no new cases from the in-house of the Thai citizen that have got the corona. And I do hope that all of you can enjoy your daily life with the new normal style. Also, wear the mask, okay, go to anywhere and wash your hand regularly, okay. Thank you very much. Okay, so along the 10 year that MWA or Metropolitan Water Works Authorities of Thailand have got the chance to share the knowledge through the IWA session. So many of the topics, just like of the water quality, just like the water safety plan, also just like the technology of water and production. So we have the chance to share many knowledge to everyone, and do hope that this is one of the session that we can share the knowledge for the non-revenue water as the group of the IWA water loss specialist group today. Yes, okay. First of all, I have to say that the Metropolitan Water Works Authority is one of the state enterprise that look after for the clean water in Thailand. And the responsibility area, we have to serve the clean water for more than 10 million people in our responsible area. So this is the very big case that we do hope that everywhere can learn the knowledge from us together. So today I would like to welcome all of you for joining the sessions of water loss management in Bangkok, a big sleepiest metropolis, around 1 hour more than this. Yes, I would like to present the presenter today is the Director of Water Loss Information Technology Operation Division from Metropolitan Water Works Authority Thailand, Mr. Wasan Hae Song Suri. Please welcome.
Okay, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone to join with this webinar. Okay, my name is Wasan Hae Song Suri. Let me tell you about my background. I have 20 years experience in water loss management. I start work with the leak detection team at our branch office. And I joined with set up the district metering area system in MWA. And now I'm interested in the water distribution network model by use Equis and ApaNet for water loss management. Currently, I take care of water loss management application system and manage the special team that we call ATTAC team, which is our leak detection team using a special equipment. I also in charge of data analysis for water loss management of MWA. Okay, before I start this section, maybe I show you some video presentation of the Bangkok City, a big and sleepless metropolitan. Okay, let's start together.
Thank you.
you will see the background of Bangkok City. Today's agenda, I have 6 issues, and we start with review MWA information to briefly let you know our pipe network and the background information in water loss management information. Then I will talk about the counter with problem in Bangkok City and how hard to manage water loss in Bangkok. And the basic knowledge how to manage water loss in MWA follow the IWA guideline and the new technology that we use in water loss management today and show some example case. And then the last section is the future next step with the information technology and summary. Okay. Let me introduction of the organization responsible for water management in Thailand, which relates to MWA. For raw water resources, it's managed by Royal Irrigation Department to supply raw water for MWA. And for drinking water or tap water section, it's managed by MWA in 3 provinces, Bangkok, Nonthaburi and Samut Prakan. And for the other provinces, it's managed by provincial water works authorities. In the past of waste water management, it's managed by local administrative agency such as Bangkok Metropolitan or the local governance agencies. Okay. MWA clearly has approximately 2.3 million customer meter. We produce about 2 billion cubic meter of water per year. We have around 24,000 ton pipe network, cover for 3,200 square kilometer of our responsible areas. And currently, our non-revenue water is about 30%. Okay, this slide is gave you some information of our production capacity and how to distribute water to our customer and information of our pipe network. Currently, There are four water treatment plants. The two huge plants are Bangkhen Water Treatment Plant is located on east bank of the Chaoya River. And another one is Mahasawat Water Treatment Plant located on west bank of the Chaoya River. The total capacity of our water treatment is nearly 6 million cubic meter per day. Our operation water pressure is 8 meter water. It's about 0.8 bar. You see, we operate on a low pressure system. It's the heart for water loss management. And we have a 17 pumping station to distribute the water to our customer. The water loss, the amount of water loss is now is 1.5 million cubic meter per day. And our pipe network, almost of our pipe is plastic. It's PVC around 80%. Okay. These are pictures show the establishments of our water supply system in the past. In the past, we focusing on set up infrastructure to respond to the growth of the water user. And now, MWA is expanded the system to cover all of service area and focus on apply technology to manage the water production, water quality control, water loss management, water distribution, and for customer services. Okay, this is the picture of Bangkok is the capital city of Thailand, the sleepless and the busiest of city. Okay, and some time when the pipe burst, it may affect to the traffic that you see in this picture. Okay, let me show you historical of water loss management in MWA. I would like to divide our water loss management into three main periods. The first period, during the founding of our organization from 1970 to 1990, the water loss rate was very high, up to 64%. As it was still in the phase of the initial pipeline construction and the meter installation, resulted the high commercial loss and apparent loss. Also, the billing system was not fully effective. In this phase, the water loss management was just a passive leakage control with focus on passive sound detection survey. That is, there was a leak survey plan in pipe route for 2 cycles per year. And we have pipe replacement project to improve the pipeline about 900 kilometers during these 10 years. Result, the water loss level gradually reduced to 35%. And the second period, from 1990 to 2000 millennium, we concentrate on water loss management program by using an active leakage control principle. Along with this period, the investment to renovate pipe network for more than 1,500 kilometers. The main strategy for water loss management by using minimum night flow monitoring and block system area management, we use to prioritize each area for leak detection survey. Cause water loss rates to fall below to 30% for the first time. Unfortunately, during this period, Thailand faced a third economic crisis called Tom Yam Goong, that you know, and we have to reduce the importance of water loss management policy. We saw that the water loss rate returned up to 40% again. So a big project is improve the water loss management was created. In the third period from years 2000 to present, we have set up a new water loss management system based on IWA guideline. Then district metering area has been setting and the real-time monitoring system for by use a magnetic flow meter and use a communication network has been installed. Also, the geographic information system has been integrated and information technology has been implemented to manage information of water loss. And we developed the water loss management application WLMA, result in systematic water loss management, ability to recognize area which pipes are broken more quickly. Moreover, with the plan to renovate the old pipe for 400 kilometers per year, the water loss can be reduced to less than 25% again. But now, the water loss problem has been increased because the old pipe system began to deteriorate, resulting that in the next 5 years, we plan to replace more old pipe to 1,000 kilometers per year and use the new advanced water loss detection technology to help us find new leak and control the amount of water loss. Okay. This is the current situation of MWA. Now, MWA doesn't have the own water supply. The raw water resource is managed from RID or Royal Irrigation Department. And now the total loss is about 1.5 million cubic meters per day. And it's nearly full of our production capacity. And the problem of the climate change, maybe some year is flood, some year we counter with the droughts. And the problem, and the future problem, we have to prepare for investment to expand our production capacity to compensate with the water loss and water demand. And the climate change leaves the water quality problem in the eastern side of Chao Phraya River with the salt water. And the managing for stakeholder requirement is more complicated in the era of globalization. Okay, this is the obstruction in water loss reduction in Bangkok. First, Bangkok is very densely populated, and there are many related agencies in this area to work together in this area. And MWA does not directly own the areas. So before doing water loss activity, it's necessary to ask for permission from the responsible department. cause a difficulty to repair or replace the broken pipe. And maybe it takes more time for repair when we found the leakage. And some pipe replacement project was canceled by the landowner. Second, our pipe system is very big and complicated. And in the old town areas, some pipe information is not clearly resulted and incomplete in GIS database update. Moreover, it's difficult to divide into sub VMA. So we need to install more boundary walls and more district meter for divide area into a sub VMA. And there's a lot of population, so it's difficult to estimate for the water demand to suitable for distribution management. Sorry. And the problem with the material of the pipe, because most of our pipe are plastic, which is sensitive to the high pressure change. Moreover, the acoustic leak detection technique is not quite effective in the plastic material because plastic is not as good as the steel pipe to lead for the sound. It's hard to find leak a sound on the plastic pipes. And the big problem is we are low water pressure operated. Our pressure is below 1 bar or 10 meter water height. And MWA has a large pipe network. It makes it difficult to find the leaks. And there are many unreported birds that we cannot find the leakage in our areas. And the equipment of sound leakage, sound leak detection is designed for pressure over 1 bar, but our pressure is less than. It's cause of the effect to the accuracy of the instrument. Okay. This is a water loss management key strategy of our organization. Main strategy is we divide the responsible area into sub-district metering areas. Currently, we have nearly 1,000 DMA in our areas. And then we develop the application for water loss management with followed by the IWA concept to manage the data from each DMA to monitoring and to prioritize the DMA for mega plan for leak detection survey. And then we use the asset management for pipe replacement projects. And now we apply the new technology for leakage survey, such as the satellite image survey, or use the in-pipe survey. And sometimes we use the hydraulic model to find where's the leakage of the pipe root. Okay, this is the basic concept of leak loss management that we have four principles for leak loss management. It's the follow IWA guideline. And the WLMA is designed follow this guideline to make the concept to reduce the water loss. First, we start from the active leakage control, by dividing sub-DMA in our area and use IT to monitoring and priority the high rate of water loss. And then we use the BOMA to control the quality of repair job. Okay. And then for the pipe asset management and for pipe replacement, we collect the data from the BOMA to evaluate the pipeline that make the plan for pipe replacements. At the top level to manage, we use the pressure management. By some area, we install the PRV in the area near the pumping station to control the pressure. Okay, can you imagine how big of our system? I will tell you, we have the biggest at the big, and we concerned with the big data. Our DMA is 100 with the 1,600 DM meter to cover with 24,000 kilometer of pipeline, and we have the 2.3 customer meter. It's very big data. You can imagine the data is flowed into our system every minute. It's a very big. Okay. And then I want to introduce our WMMA system. WMA was developed in accordance with the IWA guideline to provide active leakage control service as a tool for the area maintenance team to be able to monitor water loss rate in each DMA with the following main feature. The first main feature is for monitoring flow pressure and minimum night flow in the form of real-time data and historical data and compare current status and with amount of water loss in the past in each DMA. The next feature that helps to summarize and decide to priority of water loss reduction activity in the area to plan for field work for step test or leak detection survey. The WMA can help to summarize the water balance in its DMA. Summarize the water loss indicator such as non-revenue water, infrastructure leakage index. The next feature is for manage the field job for our operator. And the last feature is for summarize report activity and result of the operation in order to link to the asset management system to evaluate the deteriorate of the pipeline with a GIS base map and make a project for pipe replacement into the real leakage pipe route. Okay, this is an example of our system. This page is for to monitoring the flow and the pressure and monitoring for the minimum night flow. And in this feature, we can set the intervention level of flow rate and the exit level of flow rate. And we can calculate the background loss in its DMA. Okay, this is the job management for collecting data based on a mobile device for repairing, for our team, repairing team to send the job order and control the quality of the job, repairing job. Then our repairing team, when we start to repair the job, they can send the data of this job, where is the leakage and how to repair it. And then we collect this data into the GIS database. And then everybody can know that which area has the leakage, which area is under construction or have the prior replacement project. Okay. This is the slide for new technology that we apply for our water loss reduction. It's the satellite technology for leakage detection. It's to support leak detection by using image from satellite technology for leak detection. Satellite images are analyzed to scope the area to pinpoint the leak within 100 meter radius in its area, in order to shorten the time required to determine the root for pipe leak. In the past, the limiting the scope of the surveying root of leak detection by sounding pinpoint, it began from select the TMA with the high water loss list. And then we do a step test activity to divide and select where the root of pipe maybe have the leakage. And then we send our team to pinpoint for the leakage in that root. But imagine in MWA, we have 1,000 DMA and more than 500 DMA is high leak. If we set up the team for step test in 500 DMA, it take a lot of time for doing step test before finding leak by sound detection. But if we use the satellite image, you can scan all of the area, whole of area, and select where maybe the pipe burst in each area. It may save the time. Okay, this is the concept of this technology. Which now, first, the data acquisition by using the spectral satellite image to capture the image from the specific satellite, we get the raw data spectrum of the image all of area. And then in data analysis, we prepare data by radiometric correction by filter some of the spectrum from building or the man-made object or the agriculture or the hydrology, river. We filter this data out of the image. And then we this technology apply the algorithm by use machine learning and artificial intelligence to analyze which spectrum is the water with chlorine in the soil and we can know that this area maybe have the leakage, and then we get this data and send to our team for leak detection survey. Okay, this is the example of the data that we get from the satellite image. We divide, we have rating in four color. The red color is indicate for very high probability of leakage. The yellow is indicate for the high probability of leakage. And the blue is indicate for the low probability. And then our team know how much the probability of the leakage in each area. And then we send our team to leak detection survey to pinpoint where's the leakage in the pipe. This is an example of data that we receive from the embed technology. Okay. This is a successful example case. This area, we found two big leakage points from the PVC pipe with the flow rate about 50 cubic meter per ounce. This is successful and we can, when we found the leakage, we send the team to repair it. It's the picture of the pipe burst by use this technology. But if this technology is extreme accuracy, I will say no, because some leak report from satellite, we cannot find the leak, or this is the signal from the car wash shop or from the fresh market or the fortune. Maybe some area our team has not found the leakage sound, that we cannot find the leak point. The accuracy of this technology that apply in our area is about 50 to 60% of accuracy. But if we send the feedback, it can improve the algorithm for AI and it can be more accuracy in the future, because we have an example of this is the leak point, this is not leak point, that the AI can learning what which spectrum is from leakage and which spectrum is not leakage. And when we apply the new model to the accuracy is more gain for more accuracy. Okay, this is the next technology that we use. We call the in-pipe technology for leakage detection. Now, MWA has two models of this technology. The small one is leak investigator, which have the effective distance in 100 meter from the insert point. And the big one we use a JD7, which can distance for survey for 1 kilometer from the insert point. This technology, we send the camera into the pipeline and the camera can record the visual and the audio, that we can guarantee which where is the leak point? Because I can see where's the leak and I can hear the sound of leak nearly the point of the leakage. Okay, this is a demo of this Inpi technology. We send the camera into the pipeline and with the cable. And when the camera is flow into the pipe, we can see the pipe, high surface, and it's near the leak point. I can hear the sound of the leak and I can see the point of the leak. Then we can locate where the leak. And not only to survey for pipe leak, we can survey the pipe surface, the raw surface of pipe, and to survey from the pipe equipment if it blew into the ground or into the ground. We can do to know that the status of the wall. What is it closed or open? And then we can locate it, the leak or or see the inner pipeline. And where is the leakage point or where is the weakness point in the pipe? And the next, I will show you case of by use this technology in the real case. Okay. This is the our attack team, we use the special equipment and the special technology. This is not the general team, that this team is depend on water loss management department that use many, many equipment for leak detection. This team have basic equipment like the acoustic rod, listening stick or geophone, ground microphone, leak noise correlator or leak noise logger, and have the portable flow and use the JD7 technology too. Okay. The operation of attack team is not only for purpose for leak detection, but is for sustainable of water loss problem in each DMA. And we try to set the standard procedure for leak detection process. We have to use this process and transfer knowledge from to our team in the field work. It began, the first step is for office survey. Okay, the office survey is maybe from collecting basic data of this DMA to know where is the pipe, where is the big customer, and get the data of the flow and pressure from the district metering. And then the team go in the field work with the site survey. Site survey is the preliminary survey where is the valve, where is the pipe equipment, where is the locate of the big customer to plan for doing step test. And then the process of the step test. The scope of leak detection survey is divided in three steps. First step is to measure of leak water volume by use the DM meter to find to know which area has high leak rate. And then we select the route of pipe burst by doing step test or use the noise locker, or now we use a satellite image too. And then we set the team for leak detection for pinpoint by use the sound detection. And in the future, we apply the technology of artificial intelligence for supervisor that help us to make decision where is the leak point by compare the sound of leakage by the leakage sound in our database. And this system will help us to decision when we hearing the sound, is it the leak or is not leak? Okay, this is for the step test in our area. In our area, the step test activity is not only want to know the different flow in each step. It's not enough for our team. My team, when doing step test, I record for the different time when the pressure is dropped to zero in each pipe route. This data is help us to analyze that the leakage in this route is the biggest leak or the small leak. Then I record the time when the pressure is dropped to zero in each step too. Then if you know for example of the 20 cubic meter flow rate, I know that 20 cubic meter per hour is it is one point of big gas leak or many small point of leakage. Because if you know the timing of the pressure drop, if the rapidly, this point may be the big leakage. But if it slowly step down to zero, the leak rate, the leak point is maybe the smallest with the many, many smallest that our team can know that the goal of the leakage when we survey, when they walk away with the sound leak. If they found the big leakage, they know it's enough for this route. But if they know there are many small leakages, they will know they have to find many, many leaks in this pipe route. Okay, this is the showcase of our ATTAC team during last month with this standard procedure. We found the big leakage in the PVC pipe with the flow rate approximately 50 cubic meter per hour and the five small leakage in the pipeline. And then this DMA water balance reduce from 50% into 20% with this leakage. And I can see ถอยหลังปวดถอยหลังไหนแล้วป่ะมันถอยได้อ่ะ
This one
okay this is a showcase of use in pipes surveying technology by JD7 the lead investigator I will tell you about we know thatThis area has leakage, but we cannot pinpoint the leakage on the pipe, and the repairing unit team cannot repair this leakage because our customer is not sure that if you cannot prove the truly evident, is this the leakage point?They not allow us to repair this point. Then we use this technology to clearly to find where is the leak point by use the camera into the pipe. And we can, and the customer is accept, okay, this is the point, is the leak point, and they allow us to repair this.And this is another case for use JD7 investigator on Phetchaburi Road. It's near the Tourist Authority of Thailand. We found a leakage in the PVC pipe with the flow rate 45 cubic meter per hour. This is a big leakage point too.Trunk main with a big diameter. Sometimes the flow rate with can swing our camera that you see the picture maybe swing to right and to the left, and it has to special technique for our team to pinpoint the leak.Okay, the last section is the next future that we want to apply the new technology for our water distribution network with use of big data technology and AI artificial technology to improve our network into the smart water network.Is maybe a little concept of smart water network that we try to set up in our network. The information technologyWe can collect the data from any sensor that install into the field more than, not for more than a DM meter. It's maybe the sound leak noise sensor that we collect the data and put it into our database. And this helps us to find where is the leak point by using the IT technology. And we can monitoring the operation team. We apply the technology for water loss management. This can help us to know the real-time data of the leakage and help us to quickly to find the leakage point. And use the automatic all day and all night. Use the automate. Just see the last slide of me. That's it. I can want to summarize for key. I can want to our section this. We get the technology to make a more chance to find the leakage and use technology for improved high network to reduce by use the digital technology. Okay, thank you.
Yes, almost an hour that we
technology
place of the non-revenue water management in MWA. That many sessions and many topics that I would like to summarize to everyone that Mr. Rasan showed us the historicals of the reductions of non-revenue that manages based on the IWA guidance, also including the current situation that MWA face the problem. I think that this topic is maybe faced in all over the world, especially for the global warming that in Bangkok we found the flood, the drought, and right now also we found the south intrusions since the January also. And for them, so we found the south intrusions since the January also in Bangkok, especially for the metropolitan that many area don't sleep and have to work all the time. So that is the main obstacle that we cannot, the topic is maybe the leakage, yes, okay. And some of the district and sub-district that MWA try to manage, some place that we have, and some are putting the technology and apply for use the hybrid model for using of the, in identify the leakage, including the ALC or the active leakage control that we would like to apply using for more than 1,000 DMA. To join us for the summarize. Okay, the next is the technology that we use for the detect the choline in the soil to indicate the leakage point. That is very interesting thing. And Mr. Vasan show case study, just like some failure example that we cannot identify the leakage in some area because of the vehicle or the sound that the sound, yes, okay. Okay, and some of the AI technology that we would like to integrate for using together, because right now he has the many pool of the leakage sound to use. So in the near future, we will integrating the AI for using to identify the leakage. In pipe technology, leakage detection, yes, this is through the cable and the camera in the video. Yes, including the attack team. This is interesting thing that the team is try to identify by using the technical and the technology basic equipment in the car. Yes, okay, including the technology of the JD7 that to use for identify the leak investigation. And the future plans of the NWA almost would like to use the smart water network for using in the future. I think this is the overall that is very sufficient and would be the benefits for everyone for non-living water in MWA. Yes, the question that we face, there are many around two or three items that we would like to take the answer once of the how many years of the satellite experiences, right? Yes, because I think the how many your experiences in using satellite for leakage detection?
We use the satellite for leakage detection for 2 years ago.
2 years ago.
2 years ago.
But normally we already.
Normally we already use this technology.
Yes. Okay. Including the GIS also that we use since the last 10 years also graphic information.
The GIS is applied with more than 10 years.
Yeah. Okay.
But the satellite image is applied for 2 years ago.
Okay. Thank you very much. And some of the questions more if. I would like to know the strategy for integrating non-living water management with other organizations as Bangkok area has a complicated underground infrastructure and many property don't belong to Bangkok Metropolitan. How does MWA manage this obstacle? Please share the idea for other countries. Yes, please.
For not belong Bangkok Metropolitan.
Yes, okay.
It's a private or private owner.
Just like many of the organization that you have to working together. Yes.
We working together, we try to set the standard of the drawing and allocate the space of pipe repair with the standard drawing. But we can know which area I can install the pipe, which area is for communication, which area is for electricity.
I see. Yes, okay. I just want to refer to your presentation also that you try to imagine that the big city have got more than 10 million of the people and we have to integrating many projects through the Bangkok Metropolitan, including the electric authority, also including the communication and the drainage. So I think that this one's of the point that many cities in the world also face together. Yes. Okay, sure. Okay. The last question is, for the pressure is relative low, around 1 bar, but still the non-living water is still high, about 30%. Yes.
Okay. I tell you, we trade off with the high pressure, maybe the high loss, but the high pressure will give, when we use our team to sound leak detection, the high noise from the leakage that is compensated for to have more effective lead to find a new leak. It's maybe can control.
Yes, okay. Thank you. Interesting. Another next question is, does NWA have a target for in RW non-living water that you are aiming to reduce down to?
Maybe in the
near future.
Near future, yes. For 5 years, it's yes. Maybe 20%.
20%. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Oh. We do hope so. Yes. Free swimming lake detection solution in has inline free swimming lake.
Inline free swimming lake detention solution. I don't know the.
I think they mean like smart ball. Do you know the smart ball that you put into the pipe and it swims along?
Smart ball.
Or the JD7 have one ball. Called a bullet.
I see. Yeah, okay.
This project for smart ball leak detection maybe in the future.
Thank you very much. So allow 5 to 6 of the problem that we can solve the problem and share some knowledges to each other. I do hope that this is a good chance for everyone can share the knowledge and can share some question together also. Don't be worried if after the presentation is finished, we can send some information and can answer the question via the email also. Normally, Mr. Watson prepare some presentation to each other and can share to each other also. Yes?
Yes.
Mr. Gary, so I think it's going on to the last period. Anything you would like to introduce or everything you like to make the conclusion?
No, I'd just like to say thank you to both of you. I think it was a very good presentation, very interesting for everybody to understand what MWA is doing to manage their non-revenue water in a very difficult city, I think. But there are quite a few very difficult cities around the world, so I'm sure other people are interested to know. So I'll just stop the recording now and say thank you very much.
Okay, and I have to say thank you very much for all of the audience, also more than 65 audience today that joining our experiences of MWA, Metropolitan Water Works of Thailand. So we do hope that everyone will be healthy and lucky, especially for the moments of the COVID crisis like this. Okay, so I hope all of you enjoy for the new normal lifestyle. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, have to say the big thank you and have got to see you together in the next chance of the IMWA webinar. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณครับ